힐링 스루 유머. 파블로스 조크스 프롬 더 해피 헌터 바이 찰스 앤 프란시스 헌터. 포워드. I remember thoroughly enjoying Robin Williams' portrayal of the young Dr. Patch Adams, the physician who spent more time in clown garb than a doctor's garb. Patch Adams, the movie, brought the world attention, the importance of compassion, love, and humor in the treatment of patient. My soul resonated with the message that joy is vital to the recuperation of health. I could relate to the theme profoundly because I have grown up in and around the Oasis of Hope Hospital, which my dad founded in 1963 with the mission of improving the quality of the physical, emotional, and spiritual lives of his patients. His total care approach included ministering to the patient's bodies with nutrition, nutraceuticals, pharmaceutical, and physical therapy. It also involved nurturing the emotional and spiritual needs of his patients through counseling, music therapy, art therapy, prayer, hug, and laughter. It came as no shock to me when my father pulled out his penpal file full of the letter he had exchanged with the real Patch Adams since the early 80s. Daddy and Patch are two birds of a feather. When I had the pleasure of spending time with Patchy, I saw the holistic heal was no joking matter to him. He was dead serious. If you saw the movie and watched if Patchy is the same in real life, the answer is the movie presents the tamed down version. The depth of Patchy's knowledge and his commitment to humanity awed me. I was surprised to see that his doctor's bag was full of different clown nose and teeth that he allowed me to try on, causing us both to laugh. My father is the only physician I have met that would arrive at the hospital toting a guitar and a joke book. His career spanned 60 years. He was recognized with the Alternative Medicine Lifetime Achievement Award. But his biggest reward was each day that he could build a meaningful, healing relationship with his patient. I believe that the laughter with patient is not only healing for them, but it was key to the longevity of his career and part of why he's still alive today at age 87. One clinical study indicated that both patient and physician benefit from session of laughter. I don't doubt that to be true. I have often said the fear is the stronghold of cancer. Cancer is an opportunistic disease. Fear and other negative emotions are detrimental to the immune system. Depression and anxiety are open invitations for cancer to have its way with your patient, when you are able to help a person smile and laugh. I know that we increase the possibility of recovery markedly. One of my goals is to help patients get to a place where they can stare cancer right in the eye and say, "You cannot love my joy." For me, laughter therapy is not a warm, fuzzy activity. That is a nice service to offer patient if time allows. It's an essential part of our treatment program. Science has definitely confirmed the potent healing factor of laughter. Whether studies were conducted in Japan and Loma Linda, California, objective results indicate that patients who experience laughter receive a boost to their immune system as measured in the elevation of natural killer cell activity and immunoglobulin. There are also many objective clinical trials that support healing power of humor that surprised me. The few doctors take advantage of this medication. I do realize the insurance companies probably do not reimburse doctors for telling jokes, but who cares? And physicians, we should be willing to do whatever it takes to improve the health of our patient. This wonderful book, Healing Through Humor, is a great tool for doctors to use on after therapy sessions. As I mentioned, my father always brought a book of jokes with him to work. I think this book would have been one of his all-time favorite because it will keep my needle in stitch. I know that you are living in a time when everyone is panicked about medical claim and lawsuit, so I make no claim about the healing power of this book. All I will say is the science confirmed that positive emotion invoked by humor have healing effects. If you read this book and no positive emotions come about, you need to check if you have a pulse. This book is great, and I plan to prescribe it to my patient. Enjoy, Francisco Contremis, MD. Anatomy of Love. Your whole body gets a kick out of a good chuckle. Here's what happens when you laugh, according to research. Your heart and lung are stimulated. Your heart beats faster and your blood pressure rises temporarily. You breathe deeper and oxygenate more blood. Your body releases endorphins, your own natural painkiller, and you produce more immune cells. You burn 78 times as many calories as you would in a resting state. Your diaphragm, facial muscle, and internal organ all get bounced around in a massage, sometimes called internal jogging. After you've laughed, your muscle and artery relax. That's great for easing pain. Also, your blood pressure lower and your pulse drop below normal. Some researchers think all this aids digestion. A merry heart does good like a medicine, but a broken spirit is the bone. Proverbs chapter 17, phrase 22. The New English Bible translation of this verse says that a merry heart makes a cheerful countenance, but low spirits sap a man's strength. Okay.